I consider myself an artist. The utensils I use are my paintbrushes. The plate is the canvas. And I'm always trying to create a masterpiece. My name is Trey Wilcox, and I am an executive chef, and I have an extreme passion for cooking.
I watched Trey on Top Chef. He was my favorite.
Grits. Trey, you really, really came through with those cheese grits.
When I create a dish, what I'm trying to bring to my guests is the satisfaction of visually, aesthetically pleasing food and a combination that of food that is unique and is usually very easily consumed. So I'm all about the ingredients. I'm all about the experiences of great food, great times, great place. Brought to you by a great chef.
Winner of the Dallas Morning News Rising Star Chef Contest and two-time James Beard Foundation Award nominee, Texas-based chef Trey Wilcox prides himself on preparing plates and menus that offer a mixture of international flavors, ingredients, and a variety of textures that both please and excite the palate, but aren't so complex that one couldn't consider them comfort foods.
Up next on the stage, as you can see, he's been
just as important as feeding the masses is teaching them.
Chef Trey Wilcox.
You know, sometimes cooking can be intimidating, seem like it's very difficult or a little too hard to accomplish. And what I try to teach people is that it's really not. It's really just knowing the basic techniques.
The chefs who have multiple burners going up in here and is doing all this, that's probably a sign to you that that dish is probably difficult to pull off in your home.
When I'm giving a cooking demonstration or on a television set, I want viewers to walk away with a lot more feeling of I can in the kitchen.
And whether during personal appearances or on popular reality show competitions, Chef Trey makes it look easy and delicious.
On the ostrich, little salad on top.
There aren't many chefs out there like me. I've been nominated for James Beard Awards. I've won several Rising Star Chef Awards. I've been on Iron Chef. I've been on Top Chef. And I've done all this with no formal training whatsoever.
I gotta ask you a question. You don't strike me as the kind of guy who's used to losing.
You're very right, sir. It's a good observation.
My persona on Top Chef was very straightforward. I wasn't there to play games. I was there to compete. That was it. I did not know anything about Top Chef before I did the show. And I think my persona was that he's the quiet guy who's very straightforward, and he's there to win.
Now, Trey, you really, really came through with those cheese grits.
I want to be the kind of chef that steps in front of a crowd of people and captures everyone. I've been in this business for 18 years now, and the number one thing I've learned, the most important thing I've learned, is you cannot plateau as a chef. The day you do that, it's the day you're going to get passed up. And you know, it's not all just about me, because I do want to leave behind a legacy of people and chefs and cooks that say that, you know, they really got their start when they started working with Chef Trey. I want people to feel like I want to be around him. I want to be in his restaurant, you know, because once you've experienced having my food, I want people to feel like I've got to have Trey's food. I've got to go see what he's putting out there. His food is so beautiful. And, you know, if people come just to see me teach, I want people to be coming there to say, I know I'm going to learn something from this guy. I know he's going to teach me something. And, you know, hey, he's really funny to watch, too.